Good morning. It's around 5:30 in the morning. So I was thinking to make a little like a video diary about some fun facts. I mean, they are quite interesting facts, but I don't know if it will be interesting for you. But anyway, I was thinking to pile them up in this video and have it available for your pleasure. It's dark, but it's getting lighter. Now the one fact is that my room has windows, but we have this beautiful corridor next to my room. And if this corridor would have a thick wall, my mother is keeping the beautiful flowers, plants during winter in this corridor. So if this corridor would have a thick wall, then I would not have a straight looking out on the nature or on our courtyard. So the corridor was made half of glass, and it's very beautiful. In winter, of course, it does not insulate enough, so the heat is going out quite fast, but it keeps like 10-15 degrees here for the plants to survive the winter. And my room has a view. I'm not looking on the walls from all four sides. Now, another fact is that we have this beautiful big wild chestnut tree in the courtyard. And when we came here, when we bought the house, the guys who came to work, they wanted to take it out, to cut it out. And then we said, no, we don't want to cut out this beautiful, huge, big tree, because during the summer, when sometimes it gets over 30 degrees, way much, and it gets 40 degrees of Celsius, it's extreme hot, this huge tree is making a big shadow, a shade on the courtyard, on this part of the house, on my corridor. So the temperature does not go up very high. And the other beautiful aspect of it is that in springtime and in winter the sun goes very, very low. So the sun rays does not come inside my room. But in springtime, in this time, the sun goes more high and the leaves are not yet out. That's a beautiful aspect of it. And the sun rays come through very beautifully through the window of the through the glass corridor, through my window, and straight goes on my bed. So even though my room is like this, quite deep inside the house, but I get some sunshine, some beautiful sunshine. And then when the nature is waking up more and more, and we can see the big, big, big sprouts on the branches, slowly they are getting thicker and thicker and waiting for more and more warm weather. But very quickly, the leaves are popping out. And then in few days, the whole crown of the tree becomes green with fresh, beautiful green leaves. And then concerning the sunshine, it's over. The sun rays does not come into the room straight. No way, because it makes a big shadow. But I don't mind so much. Anyway, I can look out and see the beautiful surroundings in the courtyard. And that's the beautiful, like an umbrella, which is opening and closing naturally. A huge, big umbrella, which opens and closes automatically. And in springtime, the umbrella is opening slowly up and then covering the courtyard and the glass corridor. Of course, all these flowers, what you saw on the corridor, they go out. We have a terrace, and my mother puts them on the walls outside, on the tree, and on this terrace, so that the flowers are going out. So the corridor is spacious and empty of flowers. And then in autumn, September, October, when the temperature goes down, starts to get like below 10, then the flowers come back. And the umbrella, of course, is losing the leaves in the autumn, very colorful leaves. And then there is a leaf collecting activity, which I placed in few videos. Then it comes back, it loses the leaves, and more sun is getting through. We will see. It's like very hot these days, over 20 degrees, and the weather forecast says a huge drop down, cold wave is coming. We did not have snow. Jeez. I like snow. It's not like that I would like it all the time and for so many months, but I do like this four season kind of weather in Serbia or in Balkans. I like it very much. So you have everything. You have, we would supposed to have some cold winter, which is relatively cold. It can go from 10 degrees of Celsius plus till minus 10, 15. Very rarely it drops down below 20 degrees for a few days. And usually we have some snow. 3-4 times, few centimeter. 3-4 years ago we had like it was also very late in March or in April, we had some 20 centimeter of snow suddenly, and it was lasting 4-5 days. But this winter, from 2019, I think we had one morning a little white, just a little white out, little whiteness, maybe half a few millimeters, just one morning, and that's what I would not call it even snow. In Finland or where in Sweden, they have how many words for snow? 60 or something? A huge amount of different kind of expression for snow. So we did not have, and we will see this. This is March, you know what? It's 21st, yeah, because yesterday was the first day of spring. The calendar spring started yesterday, 20th of March. So today is 21st of March. And this big cold drop down, we will see if we will have a little bit of snow. That's always a fun because of the photography aspect of life. I like to make photos, and a little snow makes it very beautiful, makes it very interesting to just go out and shoot some photos, make some video, put it. I don't drive my Transalp on the Transalp in winter, in snow, not in winter. It can be cold, even minus few degrees. That does not stop me to go not very far, because even though I have the clothing, the jacket and the trousers, biker trousers and jacket, but it's not equipped like for Nordic drive, you know, around minus 15 or 20 degrees with heated parts, you know, and heated gloves. And so I don't have that special cloth, because we don't need it. We don't have so much cold. And But I do travel close by 7, 9, 10 kilometers here and there to Palich Lake. I like to go. It's close by. So what it's a beautiful little town in the north of Serbia. If you are interested, of course you can check out. There are some beautiful videos with many beautiful buildings. And the closest destinations which I very often visit is Palich Lake, a beautiful park area with hotels, restaurants and tennis terrains. And now the spa center is growing slowly somewhere in the background. That is one of my very likable destination. And the other destination is Majdan Pond. The Majdan Pond is it's naturally grown little lake in the Kelebia forest. That's in another direction. We have two border crossings to Hungary, two main one. It's Horgos, that is towards Palich Lake, and towards Kelebia. And we have one small one. Yes, and when you go through Horgos, you turn left, and there is a small, very small border crossing. So when you go towards Kelebia, there is a forest. We like it very much. And there is this little pond called Majdan. That's 14 kilometers from Subotica. Extremely, very often I go there. It's a very fortunate, beautiful combination of you can have a little pond, a lake, which is not so deep and not so wide, but it is a lake. Border of the forest, and the forest is mixed pine tree forest, and so there is a beautiful, fortunate combination of a pond and the forest and the sandy beach. Where people can walk around, and in summer and warm weather you can take a dip, you can bath and have fun. People go to make some rostélyos. This is Hungarian word for putting some meat on this grilling, of course. Families, friends, they go out and have fun sitting and listening some music, children playing with dogs and some animals, people come out with quads and motorbikes and bicycles even. The climbing club Spartak very often organizes walking projects. They are very active. They are walking every week, Saturday, Sunday. They go around like from 7 kilometers up to 15, 20 kilometers. Sometimes they go towards the Palich Lake. Sometimes they go towards the Kelebia Forest. Another interesting part of the courtyard, I will show you, is the birds. Even though we are in the almost in the middle of the city, we have all kinds of birds. Come on, focus. The sun rays are slowly rising, and you can listen the songs of the different birds. Very beautiful. Sometimes in the evening they are singing and calling each other, and in the morning these small black birds so this is our very much loved big tree, wild chestnut tree, which we kept. And these are the flowers which were inside the corridor. They came out recently because it's sort of not so much cold anymore. Okay, I would like to show you some flowers again. Some flower intermezzo. Beautiful. This is one kind. And this is the second kind. The beautiful smelly one. We call it Narcissus. Let us see, and there is this one, which is in growing tendency, of course, and slowly opening up. An interesting one. Beautiful orange. And some small ones. Sometimes some woodpecker is coming, knocking the tree, and these small little birdies, simple ones. Of course, we have two bird houses. My mother likes to feed them. You can see lots of seeds below. That is the seeds falling out of the birdhouse. Sometimes the camera doesn't want to focus really in the birdhouse, and then they can take a bath and a drink from this drinking pot. Some more flowers. While we are watching the flowers, you can hear the beautiful birds singing around if I am shutting up my mouth a little bit for the sake of greater good. These flowers are called the snow roses. They don't mind the shade, they don't mind the cold, don't mind even the snow. Very resilient plant. And it grows and expands and gives flowers early in the spring. These violet ones. Okay, let's see if the focus is coming. Yeah, slowly. Beautiful. Today will be beautiful, so my chair is waiting me, but from around 10-11 o'clock, because I have so much activity, I will have the opportunity to enjoy some more sun. And then this is the so-called golden rain. It's not a big bush we have. On the streets are full of yellow, beautiful flowers. And then we have this other kind of small bush, which will be soon full of pink sprouts. Not yet, but yes, it's coming. It's coming, full of rose, beautiful, beautiful flowers. I will, of course, make video about that also. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for this morning session of speaking about my tree, white chestnut tree, and the glass corridor. And And God bless. Enjoy your life. And see you in the next session. Thank you very much for joining the Dive Deep Inside channel. If you like something, press the like button. If you want to hit something, press the down like button. If you want to share or subscribe to the channel, you are welcome. You will have some different kind of stuff coming up very soon and in a regular base. So thank you very much once more and enjoy. Hasta la vista. Ciao.